Some crises are predictable and some there is no way we can anticipate. Even if you have a good handle on your finances, you might need to change the way you manage your money during difficult times. I share the why and the how in the next few minutes. Hi there and welcome to the Savvy Corner. My name is Alisa and this channel is all about helping you manage your money, your business, and your mind around it. I release content every Tuesday, so consider subscribing and hit the bell if you don't want to miss any future videos. Today, I want to address the subject of budgeting, especially during difficult times or crises. I will share with you why and how emergency budgeting is different than regular budgeting. I'll give you some money management tips and strategies, and we will also talk about your mindset and where you need to be mentally to overcome a difficult financial situation. Let's jump straight in. First of all, what do I mean by crisis and why is it necessary to have a different budgeting approach during such a time? A crisis can be anything from a personal issue, such as a reduction in income due to losing your job, for example, all the way to a global pandemic that has had economic consequences and an impact on your finances. Whatever it might be, the essential thing is that your financial situation has been affected and therefore, until things improve, you can't keep managing your money the way you used to before the crisis. During normal times, the purpose of a budget is to help you reach your financial goals. During difficult times, that purpose doesn't change, but the goal changes. If before your goal was to perhaps buy your first house, maybe become debt-free or build an investment portfolio, in a crisis, your goal might be not to increase your debt, to stretch your emergency fund as far as you can, and in some extreme cases, to survive with a roof over your head and food on the table until you can find another job. This approach is sometimes called emergency budgeting. Let's have a look at what it means in practice and how you can apply it to your own finances. The first thing you need to do is to review your expenditure. Have a look at everything you spend money on and categorize them into essential and discretionary expenditure. Your essentials include things like rent or mortgage, utilities, food, medicines, debt repayment, transportation. Anything that is not necessary for your survival can be classed as discretionary. Entertainment, gadgets, going out, clothing and accessories, subscriptions and memberships, etc. The aim here is to streamline your expenditure in the short term and allow your savings or your emergency fund, if you have any, to go further. So be prepared to eliminate or cut down on your discretionary purchases until things get better. Now, depending on your circumstances, you might need to be quite drastic about this. If you don't have some money set aside for emergencies and you can't rely on financial support from a partner or from someone else, then you might not have another option but to cut things out completely for a while. If, however, you have an emergency fund, let's say, you can be more flexible and allow certain purchases, but please make sure that they bring real value to your life and be intentional when you choose them. If you had any big purchases planned in the near future, you might want to postpone them until things get better financially. Perhaps you don't realize this, but even your essential expenses are negotiable. You can't choose whether you pay for these items or not, but you can negotiate how much you pay. So pick up the phone and have some conversations with your landlord or your mortgage provider, with your bank, your utilities providers, your mobile phone company, etc. Let them know about your situation and ask for their support. Can you get a cheaper rate? Is there an installment plan that you can take advantage of? Can you have a payment freeze or a payment holiday for a few months? You have to be willing to ask for help and to be prepared to change suppliers and shop around for better deals. Another thing you must be willing to do is to claim for any benefits, income support, and allowances that you might be entitled to. Every country has different rules for this, so I encourage you to speak to your local authorities or to search online to see what's available where you are. You might need to fill in some paperwork, maybe jump through some hoops, but don't neglect this aspect. Also, do you have any insurance that you can claim on? Income protection or payment protection insurance that you might have taken in the past? Again, it's worth going through the paperwork and finding out if you are eligible to claim anything. If you're getting value out of this video so far, hit the like button and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. There's only so much that you can do to optimize your expenditure, and it's important to also work on the other very important aspect of budgeting, which is your income. You won't be able to control a lot of things like the economy, the job market, etc., but there are things that you can do to bring in more money until you find another job or until your situation improves financially. And for that, I suggest that you start looking at your assets and start using them. Your assets might be things such as an emergency fund and a savings account, but your skills are also assets because you can use them to generate income. So what skills do you have that you can take advantage of and use in exchange for money? Perhaps you can do translation work, proofreading, video editing, tutoring, design. There are plenty of websites like Fiverr or Upwork where you can sell your services and make some extra money. Don't forget the physical assets that you have lying around in your house. Clothes, accessories, furniture, electronics, gadgets, books, you name it. Can you sell some of these items that are in good condition but you don't use or you don't enjoy anymore? Now could be a good time for you to declutter your home and increase your income at the same time. I promised I would talk about mindset as well and how to deal with the financial crisis mentally. I want to start by addressing using your emergency fund. Some people feel guilty or nervous about using their emergency fund due to the fear of not being able to replenish the fund or not wanting to look lazy or complacent. Perhaps they share this fund with a partner who has not been affected so much by the crisis and they feel like it's unfair for them to use the money for themselves. I have an entire video about how to deal with these concerns and I will link it for you below. I don't want to repeat myself here, but I will say one thing. Your emergency fund is there to give you peace of mind. It is designed to be used in an emergency. So give yourself permission to use this money and buy some more time and some sanity. Go and watch that video and you'll understand what I mean. The second thing I want to address with regards to mindset is feeling resistant towards claiming benefits or unemployment allowances. There is nothing to be ashamed of here. As a tax-paying citizen, you have already contributed money to these benefits, and claiming them doesn't make you lazy or a lesser person. If you are lucky enough to be part of a system that has this kind of support in place, it would be foolish of you to suffer and to not take advantage of it. As long as you've optimized your expenditure like we've discussed earlier, you know that this money will be used strictly to help you bridge a gap in income and overcome this crisis. Speaking of feeling ashamed, have you told your family and friends yet? Being open about your situation means that they can support you morally and sometimes financially, and they are aware of the problem and can even help you with making an introduction or keeping an eye out for you in terms of jobs and opportunities. You don't have to shout it from the rooftops, but telling a handful of people you love and trust might make you feel better and lift some of that burden off your shoulders. There is nothing to be ashamed of if you are in a difficult financial situation. These things happen, and blaming yourself or blaming other people doesn't solve anything. The best thing you can do is to look forward with a proactive approach and the trust that you will overcome this. And please don't compare yourself to others. You don't know what's going on for them, and what you're comparing with might just be an image that those people want you to see or allow you to see. Comparisons can negatively affect your mental health, so I strongly advise against them. Keep off social media if you have to, and don't engage in conversations that you know will leave you feeling hurt and even resentful. Instead, surround yourself with people who love you and support you. Apply these budgeting techniques and keep your mind in check. If you need to speak to a professional, there are many charities and organizations that offer free and confidential support. You don't have to do this on your own, and I want you to know that I am here for you too. Let me know in the comments if you're struggling, and I will do my best to answer any questions or to signpost you to relevant services. I hope this video was helpful, and if you'd like to see more content around the subject of money and finances, I invite you to start with the two videos that are suggested on the screen right now. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!